Hello everyone. In this short introduction, I'm going to talk about affordable vibration monitoring. First part of this presentation will define our context by introducing the fundamentals of predictive maintenance and vibration monitoring, existing products and trends in the market today, and understanding what challenges we face in our transition to Industry 4.0. The second part will be a collection of solutions, which I call a solution toolbox, demonstrating different techniques to overcome the challenge of wide-scale adoption of vibration monitoring. Yeah, forgot to mention, my name is Ahmed Neumann, system engineer in TI, focusing on building TI solutions for factory automation. Nowadays, machine or motor failures in a typical production plant become very costly. Production stop, labor time waste, and material scrap can lead to millions of dollars lost per day. Not to mention the workers' safety concern in case of unpredicted failure. Here comes maintenance into play. Over years, maintenance moved from corrective to preventive by keeping a scheduled service plan to a more efficient predictive maintenance, which means predicting when the failure would happen and take corrective steps in the most efficient way. This new approach, which comes with a minimal cost, leads to great savings on the long run and creates a safer environment for workers. Even better, this approach can be retrofitted to older generations of machines and equipment, positively impacting productivity and availability. How can we predict machine or equipment failure? Observations show that equipment failure or breakdown doesn't happen instantly. Rather, it's a continuous process of performance degradation with early signs of malfunction, typically starting with abnormal pattern of vibration. Sometime later, there might be an irregular increase of equipment temperature during normal operation, audible noise, or noticeable increase in equipment power consumption before actual failure occurs. Monitoring those parameters of machine health, current consumption, temperature, and vibration, among others, allows us to predict many types of failure modes, like misalignment in a shaft, mechanical defect in a gear, unbalance of a ball bearing, or loose fixture of a pump, etc. This process is called condition monitoring. In comparison to temperature and current sensing, vibration sensing is more demanding. First, it requires specialized sensors. Most common vibration sensors are accelerometers. Major types of vibration sensors and their typical performance ranges are shown in this slide. Servo accelerometers are the most accurate, high dynamic range, low bandwidth sensors, typically used for navigation. Charged piezoelectric sensor, where vibration is converted to tiny capacitive change, is quite tricky to use, and generally reserved for the use in very high temperature environments. Piezoresistive sensors has limited dynamic range and more common in crash tests and acceleration impulse detection. On the factory floor or process plant, you would possibly encounter either capacitive MEMS accelerometer offering low to medium performance and bandwidth, but in a small footprint, or the more industry standard integrated electronics piezoelectric accelerometer, known as IEPE. This type of sensor offers optimal performance with respect to dynamic range and bandwidth. I'm going to elaborate a bit on the IEPE sensor, as it's the industry standard for vibration sensing. Its interface is standardized, allowing virtually all IEPE sensors to work with IEPE interface modules regardless of the manufacturer. The IEPE sensor structure is shown on the upper left diagram. A sturdy sealed metal casing encloses a suspended mass attached to the casing through the piezoelectric material. When the casing accelerates, the tension forces on the piezoelectric material changes its capacitance. This capacitive change is amplified with integrated electronics, hence comes the name IEPE. Simplified circuit model of the IEPE sensor is shown on the upper right diagram. The sensor is basically a transducer followed by a charge amplifier, which is powered by a DC current called the excitation current. The sensor output is voltage signal that follows the vibration input as seen on the lower left diagrams. To allow single supply operation, the sensor is adding a DC voltage to the output signal called bias voltage, which is typically blocked by AC coupling the sensor to the interface module. Most important IEPE sensor parameters are measurement range in G's, acceleration of gravity units, sensitivity in millivolt per G, frequency range at which sensitivity is almost constant, as we can see from the typical IEPE sensor frequency response diagram on the lower right corner. Beyond this range, the sensor is not converting the mechanical energy properly into electrical signal. Though important, sensor is just one part of a vibration monitoring system. Vibration sensor is attached to the equipment to be monitored. A motor here in the picture. Sensor is powered by a control module, which is also does the signal conditioning and data acquisition. Data capture is analyzed either locally in a PLC control module, remotely on an industrial PC system, or in the cloud. Analysis is fundamentally comparing vibration signal to a healthy vibration patterns, either in time or frequency domain, to detect early signs of malfunction. How unhealthy vibration patterns are identified? This is commonly driven from a set of failure models. You can either build your own monitoring system or opt for seamless full system from top vendors like Siemens, GE, or Mitsubishi, among others in the list here. Let's have a closer look at the available products under the category of IEPE sensor input module. Interface products come in different classes. At the lower level, there is a signal conditioner, which does some amplification and filtering, generating signals to be connected to general purpose PLC high-speed analog input. Next level is the analog signal transmitter, which does some analog processing, like detecting peak or RMS of the vibration sensor output, typically converting that to 4 to 20 milliamp signals to be received by a generic analog input module. Vibration switch is similar to signal transmitter, with the possibility to switch off machine or equipment at risk through digital outputs. Data acquisition vibration input and vibration measurement tracks are specialized products that might be used for troubleshooting or large machinery or structure monitoring. Of interest to us now is the dedicated PLC vibration analog input module. State-of-the-art modules of that class achieves about 17 effective number of bits over 20 kHz of input bandwidth, with sampling frequency of 50 kilo sample per second or higher. Average web price of such module is about $500 per channel, showing why vibration monitoring modules considered as a niche products for long time. Such modules are generating data streams of more than 1 megabit per second per channel. It is quite demanding regarding processing power if analysis to be done locally, or communication bandwidth if raw data is to be sent to remote processor or a cloud. Historically, vibration monitoring was used as a diagnostic technique using measurement grade instruments or used exclusively for important and expensive equipment like turbines or large machines. Industry 4.0 promise of higher efficiency and availability manufacturing requires wider adoption of vibration monitoring to more equipment in the factory floor. This instantly brings multiple challenges. First, we just mentioned the amount of data generated by monitoring module. How to transfer this data? Raw data can be transmitted real-time through classical serial links or sub-1 GHz wireless. Second, where to process this data? As mentioned before, if we decide to process locally, higher processing power is needed. Third, how to make affordable, handy, easy-to-power modules to distribute them over large area? Fourth, how to recognize failure patterns from these data? For the first set of challenges, as they intertwined and possibly addressed together, we might use one or more of these ideas. Split processing, efficient acquisition, efficient bandwidth usage, or innovative powering. For failure detection, we might employ machine learning techniques to build failure models based on big data obtained in the cloud. We have presented some ideas in the last slide. How those ideas look like in implementation? Let's see some of our reference designs we developed over the last couple of years to show those ideas in action. All these reference designs are available on ti.com and free to reuse without any IP restrictions for our customers. Let's start by this first example, which is not necessarily vibration monitoring, but will help us showing some concepts. A large wafer fab over 5,000 square meter with hundreds of installed pumps to be monitored. Without this monitoring, there are large downtimes, power loss, and material scrap, and large cost in general. The pumps have integrated status data, reading function available through RS422. How to collect pumps data over large area of different pump types, maybe some with I/O link, so they support different interfaces. A small light design, industrial wireless condition monitoring, was made that's powered from the 24-volt field supply and supports from one side several serial interfaces plus I/O link with ability to add multiple pump type support, and from the other side multiple wireless protocols, Bluetooth for configuration and maintenance, 6-low-pan based on 6-tish for data transfer. The design is attached to the pump and connects over large area with low power through mesh network. Data is concentrated at a simple edge router based on BeagleBone platform that sends data to the cloud over the internet. This is Google Map showing sensor nodes in the real factory with the edge router shown in green. The figure aside is selected sensor real-time data shown on web browser. A trade-off between speed and power can be adjusted by setting the reading rate. The design block diagram is shown here. A dedicated chips implement I/O link, serial communication, and simple link processor takes care of the wireless communication. The used processor, CC2652 SDK, has API support for all major cloud vendors, Amazon AWS, IBM, Microsoft for all different protocols, like HTTP and MQTT. Here we show the data on IBM Watson IoT service using MQTT. Here is another design dedicated for vibration monitoring. It's an IEPE sensor interface for PLC analog input. This design achieves measurement grade performance, more than 100 dB signal to noise ratio over 20 kHz, with a signal chain BOM of less than $15 for 1 kilo unit. This design can be extended to serve more IEPE channels by maxing the input with analog mux. Actually, we don't need to monitor vibration continuously. Interleaved channel measurement is quite acceptable for many applications. Adding power, processing, and communication required components, we can get down to $5 per channel. This proves that hardware for condition monitoring is really affordable. These modules can get powered through power over Ethernet, and data concentration can be done through Ethernet network already available in many of the factory floors. That is another cost-effective design for IEPE sensing based on I/O link connection. This tiny design can be attached to the IEPE sensor or placed very near to it. It gets powered by I/O link. Data is pushed over the I/O link up to 10 kilosample per second. The integrated 14-bit ADC of the main processor is used to capture the data. FFT processing is done locally for quick failure detection. FFT is based on publicly available libraries. This is a very promising solution for applications with lower demand regarding resolution and bandwidth. This is another example reference design for wireless vibration monitoring. Sensor here is a MEMS sensor, which is connected directly to the core MCU through integrated 14-bit ADC. Fast Fourier transform analysis is also done locally. The simple link processor is used to transmit data over protocol of choice, either Bluetooth or Wi-Fi. To achieve very low power, measurement is done every 4 hours. Data is not transmitted real-time, and lower bandwidth is needed then. With such a scheme, battery life can be extended to 15 years. This is even smaller design, quite similar to the previous one. Integrated ADC within the main MCU is used. Communication processor is using 6-low-pan or Bluetooth for wireless communication, achieving ultra-low power through sparse measurement. Different here is energy harvesting circuit is used, and piezoelectric capacitive sensor is used. So we were able to collect the data and ready to process it. What's next? How to detect faults? This can be done through analytical models. This is complex, though, and depends on many parameters. Or, and that's more common, empirical models that's developed for very specific equipment and requires data sets. Or, and that's the new trend, rely on machine learning. If no historical data is available, we can rely on anomaly detection. Here is a two-parameter data set, let's say two harmonic magnitudes. Algorithms can detect anomaly points, like the red ones, are available even without training. Another technique is relying on neural processing of input spectrum to get simplified one where failure patterns look more obvious. This processing can be done fully on an industrial Cortex M4 processor like Citara. Thanks for your attention. Don't forget to check our condition monitoring gateway on ti.com for further information.